Moon Jelly Kevin here, and today I'm going to be talking about Darkstalkers. Now, I have a lot of Darkstalker stuff here on the side, but I'm going to hold up just one. This is Vampire Darkstalkers Collection. This is the PS2 version. And for me, this was the way to enjoy Darkstalkers for the longest time. You guys can see you got the secret character being teased over here. It's Donovan, who has given in to his dark ways, his vampiric ways. So that's pretty cool that that's something exclusive to this version. So this is not completely obsolete. You can still hunt this out. I personally love playing my games on the CRT TV, as you guys can see on the back. But there's definitely a more accessible way to play these games, which is the Capcom Fighting Collection, which me personally, I am a nerd, and I wanted to make sure that this was successful. So I have this on PS4, I have this on Switch, and I also have it on Steam, which you guys can see is running side by side with my camera right now. So, pretty cool compilation that just came out this year. So you got Darkstalkers, Night Warriors, Darkstalkers Revenge, that's Vampire 2. You got Vampire Hunter 2, which is the updated version of Night Warriors, although it kind of plays more like Vampire Savior. And then you have the two Vampire Savior games, Vampire Savior 1, Vampire Savior 2. But of course, the game that most people kind of associate with the series is Vampire Savior. So I have a couple copies of that lying around. I have over here, this is Vampire Chronicle for Matching Service. This is, I believe, the exact same thing that's on the PSP. I have a digital version of that. That's the Chaos Tower. You also have Vampire Savior on the Sega Saturn right here. So that's another way you guys could play the game. I know those are not particularly arcade perfect, and the most arcade perfect is to get an arcade board. You know, even things like these, you know, you're just kind of getting close enough. Even if you go emulation route, it's still close enough. But, you know, close enough is better than nothing, I would say. And I'd say these are pretty darn near perfect, in my opinion. But yeah, let me talk about my history with the series, because it is a long and interesting one. Maybe not a long one. We'll see how long this goes. Right over here, I don't know if you guys could see this, but this is Darkstalkers 3. Now, this disc over here is not my Darkstalkers 3. Where is my copy of Darkstalkers 3? I have no clue. It disappeared. I move around a lot. It's bound to happen. But my history with Darkstalkers was with Darkstalkers 3, the PS1 version. And prior to that, honestly, the most I had ever seen of Darkstalkers was promotional art for Night Warriors. So you have over here, this is Night Warriors, Darkstalkers Revenge. It's a four-part OVA that's based off of the second game. And I would see this artwork, and, you know, I don't know, you know, you could probably just say, hey, I was a horny teenage boy, and it kind of attracted me to it. But this was everywhere. I can't stress that enough. Like, if you were in the 90s and you were getting the anime, you would see this wall scroll, specifically of Dimitri and Morgan, like so. And this artwork, too. You would see this quite a bit. And it was kind of cool. I remember that this was done at least by the character designer of Gundam Wing. I don't know if it's the same animation studio, but it was at least the same people that did the Street Fighter 2 animated movie. And as far as an adaptation of the Darkstalkers universe, I'd say this is pretty darn good. With the only problem being that it's based off the second game. And a lot of my love is based off the third game, which, you know, they never made an adaptation of that, or we could talk about that in a bit. But yeah, so anyways, going back to me as in the 90s, I would buy anime magazines like Animerica, or even like, I think I saw these, I want to say, in an advertisement for for these VHS tapes, but it would be on the back of like something like the Pokemon comics back in the day. They were released as floppies, which you know, nowadays you just get the manga, it's the full tankobon. But back in the day, they actually tried to release them into single floppies. And I don't have the comics on, but just to show you what I'm talking about, like, Yeah, they would come in like single issues, and it was like Gen 13, but that's just an example of like what we were dealing with back then. You would get one manga chapter in like a single floppy. And then, yeah, when I would look at the ads, they would have ads for Night Warriors, this anime adaptation, and the manga, which I also have right over here. And I've always wanted to play Darkstalkers. I, as a kid, was in love with horror. And specifically, like the universal horror, movies like The Wolfman and the Creature from the Black Lagoon, Dracula, Frankenstein's monster. I even like the Hammer horror stuff. I think that was a little bit closer to my time. So when I saw that there was a fighting game where it was all just horror monsters, I wanted to play it. But the biggest barrier of entry as to why I could not get a copy or could not play Darkstalkers was just I was poor. Like I was a kid too, so it also didn't help that I was poor and did not have a job, and I would just flip through these magazines. Now, this is just Anime America as an example, but I would flip through my EGM magazines back in the day, and back in the day they would tell you how much things would cost. And Darkstalkers 3, for whatever reason, on the PS1, even though it's pretty well known that that's not the greatest port of the game, was like $100 or something like that. So it was something that was beyond my wallet. And eventually I would get to play at least the first Darkstalkers in the arcade, or Night Warriors are so similar that I kind of get them mixed up all the time. But Vampire Savior would not come until 2001, and I was able to buy my own copy. Again, this is not the copy. This is the case that it came with, Darkstalkers 3 on PS1. Now, what had happened was GameStop was making its way for the PS2 era. So they were getting rid of all their PS1 stock. It was going for dirt cheap. And I was able to pick up a copy of Darkstalkers 3. Now, the biggest problem was I was the only one who had this game. So even though I had like a weekly meetup, I had friends show up to my house on Saturdays, we would just play fighting games. Nobody was able to get at my level. Nobody was able to really experience and understand the game because back in the day, there was no digital. You either just had the copy of the game and you were good at it, or you didn't. So I was the one guy who was good at this game. Flash forward to college, and I ran into this guy. He's the anime club president. And he was just like the biggest, POS, biggest piece of shit, I'll just say it. Like he was just really hard to be around with, very snotty, very judgmental. And he claimed to be like the biggest Darkstalkers fan. So it was one of those situations where I don't like this guy. I'm in college. I don't like this guy, but at least he's similar to my hobbies. Maybe I'll get to play him. And that's when Darkstalkers Resurrection came out. And I bought the game. And he didn't buy the game, even though he claimed to be like this huge fan. And in fact, that's how it generally felt. Everyone claimed to be this huge fan. So just to reiterate, I was playing Darkstalkers 3 in 2001. Pretty religiously for roughly over 10 years, and then 2013 hits, and Darkstalkers Resurrection comes out, and I'm looking for people to play, and nobody wants to play this game. Nobody bought it. I mean, notoriously, it apparently flopped, which I don't think it flopped that bad, just not at the sales number that Capcom wanted. So, flash forward to today, and you finally have the Capcom Fighting Collection, and all is good because now I can finally play people. Recently hit gold rank with my character of Lilith, then I lost the gold rank, then I won it back. So, I figured it'd be nice to just talk about just Darkstalkers and my history with it. Some other things of note, there is the Darkstalkers Udon comic right over here. This came out around the same time that the Street Fighter comic came out as well. Let me see if we can get the date on this guy. This was May 2005, so pretty cool. You got a Shinkiro art there, complete with the George Clooney face. if you look at, I think it was Sarumaru who told me that, where it's like if you look at all of Shankira's faces at some point, you just start to see George Clooney. But yeah, that was the comic, and this comic is okay. It's not like, mind-blowingly crazy. But as a guy who barely got any Darkstalker stuff, it's like it's one of those things that like, oh, you'll just take whatever anything you can get. We also got over here the Darkstalkers manga, Vampire Savior manga. This one stars Lilith, and this one is done in a manga, tankobon style. Sadly, this was never translated, but if you really want to read it, you could read it online. And yeah, just good stuff. All right, so right over here we have Darkstalkers, the official complete works. I believe that this is a bunch of art books combined in one. For the longest time, you could honestly only get this through importing, and importing it was a pain in the butt. It would be like $100 or more to get the copy of this book. But Udon Entertainment localized it a few years back. It says over here retail is $44.99. I know for sure I didn't pay $44.99 for this guy. It was definitely less than $20, but it is cool because part of what makes the series so endearing is the artwork, like the energy of it. It's not just that it's like dark and spooky. It's a little bit like playful and fun, and it has a lot of energy. It's a lot more bright and colorful for something that, people just kind of associate with horror, but get a lot of cool stuff there. And I'm sure a lot of this stuff is also seen in the gallery mode, which let's actually go through some of that gallery mode stuff. So let's actually look at that. I'm sure you're gonna see the same stuff in here that you're gonna see there. So let's take a look. So first off, we have right over here this cover art for Vampire Savior. They've been using that one since like the Sega Saturn, so you guys can see. Oh, up next we have a picture of Dimitri. Dimitri, I have a strange history with, or a weird story to talk about. So back in the day, pre-social media, we would go on message boards, and I was on a message board for a game called SNK versus Capcom Chaos, which you guys could already tell from the title, has SNK characters, like the Neo Geo lineup people, so people from the King of Fighters. You got Kyo, Yori, Athena, Terry Bogard, that sort of stuff. And then you got Capcom guys like Ryu, Ken, Sagat, all those people, right? The Street Fighter people, all in this game. So I was on this message board for SNK versus Capcom Chaos, and that was the very first time, and we're talking like early internet, maybe around like 2004, 2005, that I ever seen hentai, because not by choice. I promise you, man, like not by choice. I had posted on a message board, and I was a kid at the time, like definitely early teens. I posted, I love Athena. Athena's my favorite character. Athena from the SNK games, from, well, the game Athena, and then Psycho Soldier and King of Fighters. So I love that character, and for whatever reason, the SNK versus the SNK and Capcom rivalry back in the day, like you're either an SNK guy or a Capcom guy. I was both. So excuse me. This one guy, I guess he wanted to stick it to me, so he was like, "Hey, take a look at this." And he sends me a link, right? You couldn't just embed a photo on the message board, and he sends me a link, and it's of an image of just Donovan. Oh, not Donovan. Dimitri, just giving it to Athena. And I just remember being just I don't know if he's doing to troll me or offend me, but I was like, man, yeah, the internet sucks. That's what I was thinking. I know, teenage boy should be like internet rules, but if you want it, you want it. If you want it, you'll search for it, you'll find it. If you don't want it, like, it shouldn't be shoved in your face. So at least that's what I thought at the time. So that's what I think of when I think of Dimitri, just that he's this, you know, guy who goes around being an offender or whatever. John Thalbane, right over here. Kung Fu Wolfman, who doesn't love the Kung Fu Wolfman? Victor. Yeah, you can't take this game too seriously when the guy fights with his butt, right? And grabs you with his butt. Morrigan, classic. Anacharis? I've never been sure how to say that guy's name. Lord Raptor, Zabel, Felicia, Bishamon, Albath, Rikuo. We got Sasquatch over here. Lele or Senko, whichever one you want to go with. BB Hood or Beletta. And my girl, the one I play as, is Lilith. Now, I kind of have this... Oh, there's QB. I'll tell you guys my little story in a bit. But there's Jetta. And there we go. So, yeah, here we... You can see the artwork for Vampire Savior. Got a Lilith over here. And my Lilith story... The reason why I play as Lilith is because back in the day... You know, this was like pre, like, really strong, established... FGC stuff, you know, fighting game community stuff. So most of the time you just got to play with like casual people, people who are just, you know, learning the game, just trying to learn the game to have fun. And for whatever reason, Lilith had this reputation of just being shitty Morrigan, you know, not as good as Morrigan. And I thought that her moveset was super endearing and entertaining. So I became a fan of her ever since. I love the Gloomy Puppet Show. I love her playful spinny axe, you know, Tatsu thing, even though it's completely useless in a match. I love her grab and arrow throw. So these are all things that I really enjoyed about Lilith, and I've been a Lilith main ever since. Even to the point, like I said earlier, I had a figure of hers, and I don't buy anime figures of anything. And I got a lot of flack for that figure. Like, a lot of my friends come by and they saw me with that Lilith figure. They would say all sorts of nasty things and accusations about me. And just had to take it because that's my favorite character. I can't... It's just, she's my child, alright? I'm pretty sure I'll show you guys at some point on this video the fan art I did of Lilith recently. I'm telling you guys, he's like an offender, man. Alright, so at this point, I am going to cut some footage of me playing some Vampire Savior. Hopefully you guys are enjoying this game too. And let's go. Alright guys, so this is Vampire Savior, the Lord of Vampire. This is the third Darkstalkers game. The one that is mostly considered to be the competitive one. But, you know, even from just a casual perspective, my own perspective, it's a lot of fun. It's very fast-paced, very offense-oriented, and those are all things that I enjoy. For some reason, this game clicks with me. I do enjoy the Versus games, like the Marvel vs. Capcom games, but when you get to Capcom 2 and beyond, my brain struggles to get it, so... Hat! Not even close. 0 points! This guy has the one buttons on. And he's picking the B, Evil Burrito 99. Here we go. Very mellow match, but you know, kind of what makes things mellow sometimes is honestly just the stage. That and you know, really depends on who you're fighting against. I think this guy just really wants to hit that. Is this too casual? It might be a little too casual. Not too intense. That's the thing. Sometimes when you play this game and you guys get really into it, it gets your heart pounding and hand shaking. This one's pretty mellow. This should be fun. Dimitri is, he's a big keep-away character. And, that's why I think, like, with him, I get a lot of timeouts. I don't actually get a lot of, clean wins against him, to be honest. And when the guy has expert timing on that DP, this guy, unfortunately, had some poor positioning here, but that DP is like godlike in this game. Cool stuff. I appreciate he was going for the Midnight Bliss. Yeah, if a Morgan gets far, they're definitely going to be going for that. The needles. Not the needles, the missiles. As they should. Ooh, I went for it. You can tell from the jabs, maybe, maybe not. This person was going for Darkness Illusion. Got another challenger here. Same guy. Okay, let's go, HAL 81. I appreciate that this guy is going for his normals. Doesn't quite have the spacing down on some of them. That's definitely part of his game plan. There we go. This guy's got it. Or does he? You guys can probably see now, that's what I was talking about. You can kind of bat your way to victory here. It's not, you know, the most fun way to play, but, you know, for some characters, that's the rule set, you know? Like, you can't just attack them head on, especially if the opponent knows what they're doing. Again, older Capcom games, grabs are kind of strong. Ooh, he got me. Grabs are kind of strong, like I was saying. You kind of have to go for that with Lilithia. Oof. Oh, that's not dead. Now it's dead. Got a hype dog in the back. Going nuts. There's some stages I actually like more than others, like, in this game. And this is one of the ones I like. Like, ones that actually have, like, calming music. I actually prefer. Like, if we're playing on, Fetus of God. Oh, or the train stage. I actually do not like my. I mean, it's not that I don't like that stuff. Like the art's great, the music's great, but like, man, just gets me too like too pumped. Whereas, you know, this is like it's a nice relaxing game of Vampire Savior. Kind of silly, but sometimes, like, some people will just fall for sweeping the leg 3 times in a row. Man, that would have been a perfect DI confirm, or LI confirm. Ah, and that also would have been a perfect LI confirmed, but, kind of botched there, or just Link. Whatever. Still kind of a little newbie here, but if you plan on using her, get used to using those chops and that for middle kick. Middle kick I'm not really too good at using. Usually you cancel dash into that, but yeah. Like any other fighting game, you know, it's all about knowing your distances. Sometimes you want to go for the chop. Sometimes you want to go for the bat. Sometimes you want to go for DP. But, you know, in general, the game plan with Dimitri is usually you want to hang back and just annoy the hell out of your opponent. But this guy is... he's moving forward, so he's gonna be taking a bunch of bats to the face. Oof. Oof. Going for the I think he was going for his raging demon, which I'm not too sure I know what the command is. That was it. He has like two, right? I think he has that and the Midnight Bliss. I think the optimal way to play Lilith is more grounded, but when people don't really know, you could abuse some of these normals. Of course, on a computer you can't really can't really abuse them as much. Ah, they sure can abuse you. Look at that, that's crazy. Just go for the same thing over and over again. Wow, and a tech hit to add insult to injury. Yeah, so I don't know if they do a Darkstalkers 4. Is Lilith coming back? In the story, she gets reabsorbed by Morrigan, and that's it. So we'll see. I would love to see a Darkstalkers 4. I think there was a lot of potential there. If honestly it was just Vampire Savior, but just rebalanced and added all the characters that were missing, like Kutzil and Donovan and who's the last one? Pyron. You know, just rebalanced and added some new characters. I would like to personally see Anita. You know, I think that's kind of a loose thread we'd love to see. Just what is she like now that she's older? And yeah, that's it. That's Darkstalkers. That's a classic Capcom game. Selfishly, I would like to see some of Lilith's weaknesses kind of fixed and addressed, such as you know, her hop grab is it's pretty not satisfactory, let's put it that way. I think if she had just a regular command grab, it would definitely help her out a bit. Alright, so that's Vampire Savior, Darkstalkers 3, a game of my youth. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that, and thank you guys for watching, and have a wonderful day.